the convenient situations everything placed in the characters, the story, like the whole thing started, you know, when Sugimoto, this thing, the gold, the search, like, how it conveniently just took place around him and it just started around him.
It seemed to be almost seems generally too absurd how many players in this game managed to come by to one place. And Brew also made the point that this thing, certain people who had no business with the gold at all was there even otherwise for some particular reason.
Okay, wait, wait, one sec. We gave a lot more context when we originally recorded. Yeah. Basically, these prisoners all escaped, 24 different prisoners. And from the minute Sugimoto, the protagonist, finds out about the skins, I don't know why I'm touching my shirt when I'm saying skins, but from the time Sugimoto found out about the skins, tattooed skins, tattooed skin convicts started appearing around him like they were generated by a computer. That was that where Sugimoto finding out about the skins was the trigger. And it's almost absurd because Hokkaido is a huge place compared to one single human being. And 24 people should be able to hide very easily. And dude, even if they couldn't,
they were in
other
Abashiri,
people would have found them and killed them.
Dude, Abashiri and Otaru are like ends of Hokkaido, opposite to each other, you know, that to the prison and the city. So yeah, it's a huge freaking place.
Yeah, and these prisoners, some of them literally wanted to forget about the gold, forget about the prison and just go live their life. But for some reason, were in the exact same place that everyone else was looking for these prisoners. Interestingly enough. Yeah, now go on.
Yeah.
Also, I'm looking here because these guys are on Discord and on the screen. I forgot to mention that,
Also, the characters to me seem like really empty, without substance. I said like I saw in like Fire Force and stuff, like, you know, especially Sugimoto, so-called the immortal.
Hot potato,
just
check it
seemed
out.
To be a title on him, right? He didn't really have much going for him. I would say it just seemed I couldn't connect with any of the characters at all. Yeah.
For the amount of bravery and, you know, power that he shows in every single arc, he seems like a very empty character, as you would say.
Yes, and he keeps yelling I am immortal Sugimoto every time he's in danger, and that seems to be a cheat code that he applies to this game.
Yes, apparently that does. Exactly,
like it's the plot armor cheat code that he has to say every time.
It's like what the fuck mode, where, you know, you get like all your health back no matter how much damage you take, and you can just use unbelievable skill apparently. But yeah, he, in one scene, he gets shot, I think he gets shot twice, and then he just jumps out of the window with someone else and escapes away on a horse, and he doesn't die at all.
Yeah, it also, check out our tropes video coming out soon, because it did seem to be one of the things he kept repeating, I'm immortal, I'm immortal.
Every single time.
Every single time. He's like, oh, you want to find out why I'm called immortal? Oh, you know, I'm immortal. Interesting.
Man, like,
for a guy who
doesn't talk, who doesn't want to think of the war and all too much, he literally shows off about it all the time.
He does.
That is true.
Like, I don't want to bring up the past, but I'm immortal Sugimoto, you know.
Like, when a character is happy, usually when I'm reading, I feel happier. When he's sad, you feel the pain. But here, I feel nothing. It's like dead. He's like, he's just saying things and words are coming out and
it's
like expressionless.
It's,
like,
I think the agenda of his, I think his motives and his agenda is just basically, at the end of the day, money. And we don't relate to, like, you know, having to go in search of a pile of gold and go into a full battle royale mode with this
shit. Speak for yourself. I would love to go searching for a pile of gold.
Yeah, it's not that.
In a battle royale?
Instantly. That's what I would die instantly. But I'd be the first one to die.
I see.
I will admit that. Nobody will even have to kill me. I'll die in the wilderness. But I would love to go searching for it.
But it's not even about his purpose. Like, even if he has a purpose, like, you know, usually, I think Brew will be able to explain this better. You know, what makes you like relate to a character, and you know, well, not even relate, what makes you connect with a character, you know, follow their story, want to know about them, like, you know?
Well, it's basically their ideas, their goals in life, where it makes you think of what they're doing and how they're speaking and
how they
that
react
and
to certain situations, their intent, right, when they're saying certain things, doing certain things. And here it just seemed like empty, like, interactions and dialogue with no purpose to me.
Yeah, like a very good example of this would be a similar character in many aspects, actually, is Spike Spiegel from Cowboy Bebop.
Don't even fucking compare them. Come on.
No, I'm saying like they both are people who came from a very violent past with a lot of kills on their hands,
yeah.
And they're looking for something new. But Spike really makes you want to care for his journey and what he's doing.
Sure.
And when he says stuff like "I have one eye on the past and one eye in the present," you're like,
that shit hurts. Yeah.
Adds to his character.
Yeah, Spike, you can actually feel it. You know.
Yeah.
But here is just empty. Yeah, here you're like, okay.
Here is Sugimoto the Immortal. With knife and gun in hand, and you know, plot armor to always protect his ass.
Yep.
Yeah, that
man.
One.
They don't make armor the same way anymore in this current world, you know.
Yes, that's why it seemed really this to me. I was also reading it really slowly because of that. But I did love fucking Hokkaido when they mentioned Asa, they were going to Otaru. I was like, fucking nice, I want to see Otaru. And then I googled pictures of Otaru in the past to see how it actually looked in the past.
Did they have pictures of the place then?
Yeah, of course. They have a lot of pictures.
Not in that time, I'm assuming.
Yeah, not in that time.
Not
really.
In that time, yeah. They do. But yeah, it's pretty cool. And
yeah.
Also, this thing. One, my last point that I wrote here was... the facts don't fit the story. By that, what I mean is, like, I like the cultural points they gave about the Ainu. I found it interesting, you know, a few things. But they seem to not at all be related to the gold rush or this thing. It seemed like two different things that were happening at once.
Yep.
Like, it was interesting for me to find out, but... I was like, okay, after a point I was like, okay, he's going to a forest and then suddenly I'm getting a mini documentary on how these guys live, you know, like, which is still interesting, but it didn't relate to the story at all, like, they didn't fit together.
The main
so for
story,
me, it seemed
yeah.
to be, like, very, like, confusing, you know, like, the manga was kind of confusing for me, but this even made it more, because remember I told you I still reread the first few chapters again. To understand if they explain how people started showing up, but I couldn't find